Hi, my name is Jackson Bird, and today I'm debunking some myths and fears you might have heard about testosterone. But first, some disclaimers. There is so much about changes from testosterone that is difficult to attribute to testosterone alone. The changes can depend on so many factors, from your genetics, to your diet and exercise, to your living situation, mental health, and other medications you might be on. So take everything with a grain of salt, and know that you won't necessarily see the same changes as other transmasculine people that you see on YouTube or Instagram. For example, I'm 3.5 years on testosterone and can't grow whiskers on my chin at all, even though I see some guys with full beards after 8 months. It really is different for everyone. But a couple of things that are almost certainly guaranteed are sweating more, getting more oily, and getting at least a little facial hair at some point. Starting T requires new, extra attention on your personal hygiene, which is why I am proud to be working with Dollar Shave Club, who has sponsored today's video. Whether you're on T or not, we've all got our everyday grooming routines. But if you are on T like me, especially over the summer like this, you need as much help as you can get battling that sweat and keeping smelling fresh. But no matter your routine, Dollar Shave Club, yes, that Dollar Shave Club, has everything that you need: toothpaste, body wash, razors, and more, to help you look, feel, and smell your best. Even as a longtime loyal customer, I did not realize that they had moved beyond razors, but I am so stoked because all their products are so high quality, they smell great, and totally fit into my aesthetic, if I'm being honest. I also love that it's a mail order subscription service because, you know, as trans people of any identity, going out to the store to buy grooming products can sometimes be dysphoria inducing. So it is great to have a trusted company that will send fantastic products straight to your door and not have to worry about the cashier and fellow customers judging you. And now Dollar Shave Club is basically giving away their daily essential starter set to new members for only $5. And the starter set features 3 trial size versions of their most popular products that help you stay fresh and clean, along with their executive razor. So in your first box, along with these little newspaper things for the bathroom that I always love reading, you will receive their shave butter, their one wipe Charlie butt wipes, which are actually really great even though they sound silly, and their Wanderer body wash. Now I love this one. It has become my go-to travel soap because it just smells really good, and it's called Wanderer, so it makes me feel adventurous. You will also get their executive razor, which includes the premium weighty handle and a full cassette of cartridges. And then after the first box, replacement cartridges are sent for only a few bucks a month. And this $5 offer for all of that is available at dollarshaveclub.com/jacksonbird. That again is dollarshaveclub.com/jacksonbird. Thank you again to Dollar Shave Club for sponsoring today's video and keeping us all smelling fresh and looking and feeling great. And now let's move on to testosterone myths and fears. Myth number one, you'll get taller. No. Unless you are one of those rare teenagers whose growth plates haven't fused by the time you get approved to take testosterone, you will not be growing taller at all on testosterone. Really wish you did, but alas, not. Myth number two, T makes you gay, or straight if you were gay. Basically, a lot of trans people report a change in sexual or romantic identity after taking hormones, and the jury is still out on whether this is actually some effect of the hormones or, more likely, in my opinion, a combination of social and dysphoria factors. Basically, say you're a trans guy who was into women before starting T, and then found yourself attracted to men afterwards. It's possible that a subconscious reason you weren't into men before was because they triggered all kinds of dysphoria and, like, weird jealousy in you, and the reverse can also be true to a trans guy who was into guys before starting T, might have gotten dysphoric around women, and then, after being a bit more confident and assured in yourself on T, those factors fade away. Or maybe your sexual identity was more about sameness and difference, or, you know, like homo versus hetero attraction, and not the actual gender about the person that you were into. Or maybe you just spend so much time thinking about gender that it's all become completely arbitrary in your head, so, like, why not be attracted to all genders? I mean, there are so many possible explanations, and it's definitely not a guaranteed change from T. Myth number three, you will become a short-tempered, overconfident manterrupter. So research on testosterone shows that it takes super extreme, like overdose of steroid amounts of testosterone, for it to have any effect on your anger levels. If you do find yourself being quicker to anger or having more drastic ups and downs after starting T, it could be a result of your body just adjusting to a change in your hormones. The same type of hormonal change that can happen when you're on a new medication of any kind or when you're pregnant. It's not a symptom based on the type of hormone, just a change in hormones. And that's a symptom that's temporary as your body adjusts. You also might think about taking stock of your life. Starting tea and dealing with the way that people around you are treating you differently and how they're adjusting to the change in you can be super stressful and totally cause outbursts and distress. So, to whatever extent that you're able to, I definitely recommend you find a professional to talk to. Now, as far as being more confident and assertive and turning into that guy that none of us wants to be, this is more likely social as well, in my opinion. Like, as soon as people see you as a guy, they're gonna start listening to you, not interrupting you, deferring to you, assuming you're an expert when you're not. And even if you think all of that is stupid and misogynistic, and it is, it might still affect your confidence in a positive way. There is a great quote from neuroscientist Robert Sapolsky in Thomas Page McBee's new book, Amateur, which is an amazing analysis of masculinity by a trans man, by the way. The quote is, "If our world is riddled with male violence, the core problem isn't that testosterone can increase levels of aggression. The problem is the frequency with which we reward aggression." So basically, thanks, society. And you know, also, as T helps with your dysphoria and you start appearing and getting treated as the gender that you are, of course you're gonna feel happier and more confident and energized. So there's just a bunch of reasons why you might change emotionally on tea. Myth number four, more testosterone equals better. First, just to clear some things up, everyone has both testosterone and estrogen in their bodies. Generally, people who are assigned female at birth have more estrogen and vice versa for AMAB people, although not necessarily always. And every person's body is going to absorb and process tea differently. So there's no one size fits all prescription amount, and more tea is not necessarily gonna lead to quicker, more extreme changes for you. And when you have too much testosterone, your body actually converts it into estrogen. This is why it is so important to get your levels checked with your doctor regularly to make sure that your T levels are in a healthy zone. Myth number five, your hips will go away. Speaking from experience here, my hips are as wide as they ever were, but T made my waist wider and I built up my shoulders, so my hips like look less apparent. Fat redistribution does not work as quickly or as reliably as some trans mass people make it look like it does, especially ones who are more fit before they started T. And when you're looking at trans mask people like on the internet, remember that we're all just as dysphoric as you, and we're probably angling ourselves in photos and videos to make sure that you can't actually see the parts of our bodies that we don't like. You know, at the end of the day, good diet and exercise can help a lot, but nothing is guaranteed. Myth number six, you'll get cancer. All right, so despite anecdotal evidence that people on T for 5 to 10+ years might experience some complications that lead to needing a hysterectomy, there's not any medical literature that shows evidence of T causing ovarian, cervical, or endometrial cancer. Of course, there's just not much medical literature of trans people at all, so take that with a grain of salt. T can increase bad cholesterol, or HDL, increase blood pressure, and decrease your sensitivity to insulin. So overall, you're at a higher risk for heart disease, stroke, and diabetes, just like all men are. Your risks aren't any greater than any other man. And these are all things that your doctor is aware of and will be checking for when they regularly check your T levels. Myth number seven, you will never cry again. So a lot of people have trouble producing tears in the first year or so. And I say producing tears because some can still cry. It's just like the dry heaving version of crying without any tears coming out. It's a really weird and frustrating experience. And some people generally do get less emotional and might not feel the temptation to cry as much. That pretty much happened to me, although it also could have been the other medication that I was on at the same time. And also the whole not crying thing is usually a lot more extreme in the first like 6 to 12 months. I feel like my emotions have leveled back out to closer to where they were. I cry regularly while watching This Is Us. So don't you worry. Myth number eight, you'll go bald immediately. All right, so your hair is gonna recede to a more masculine hairline, like right around here and at your temples, so you will lose a bit when you first start testosterone, but don't freak out just yet. It'll probably calm down after that. And then, depending on your age and genetics, yes, you might start losing your hair at some point. Look to male relatives on your mom's side and check out the ample resources all over the internet for male pattern baldness. It's like erectile dysfunction. Every man is freaking out about it, so there's a lot of research and a lot of solutions. Myth number nine, you'll get a flat chest. So strictly just from taking tea, you might see a little bit of a reduction because of the general fat redistribution that's happening, but unless you had like the smallest of smallest ever chests before, it will not make your chest flat. If anything, you might think that it's getting flatter because you're losing some elasticity from binding, so be careful about that. Myth number 10, your period will stop completely. Actual bleeding should stop stop for most people within 1 to 6 months. Some people might actually see it get a little worse before it stops, so beware of that. But for the most part, it should stop, and it's awesome. Another thing to know is that if you miss doses, or if your levels become unbalanced for whatever reason, your period might come back, or you'll see some type of spotting. So that is another reason to get checked up regularly. Myth number 11. You don't need to go to the gynecologist anymore. Just because you're not having periods doesn't mean you can't get any number of diseases or infections or other issues and complications. So continue seeing a doctor for regular checkups downstairs. And on that note, you still gotta check for lumps post-top surgery. Like, top surgeries are performed by plastic surgeons, not oncologists, and they still leave a good amount of breast tissue, which means you're still at risk for getting breast cancer. I know checking all of this stuff, especially in a doctor's office, is like super dysphoric, but think how much more dysphoric it would be if you have a complication you caught too late and then have to pay even more medical attention to that part of your body. Being trans isn't great. It's just, there's a lot of things that suck about it. Myth number 12, you can't get pregnant. So while you shouldn't count on being able to ever get pregnant after starting T, it is entirely possible, and it has happened to a bunch of people, so make sure that you're still using effective methods of birth control if you're, you know, having types of sex that could lead to babies. Myth number 13, you have to use a big scary needle. Not necessarily. There are testosterone gels and even starting to be like patches and pills in some jurisdictions. Every method comes with pros and cons, which you can review in some of the resources I've included in the description box. And when most people are using a big needle that's like going into the muscle of their thigh, that is called an intramuscular injection. This was the common standard for many years, but a while ago, doctors started introducing subcutaneous injections for hormone treatment. Subcutaneous uses a much smaller needle and is injected into your fat. It's not completely painless, but it is way less painful and way less scary than intramuscular. Intramuscular injections do absorb drugs more quickly, but research studies have proven that absorption rate doesn't impact the effects of hormone replacement therapy, and that subcutaneous injections are an effective and safe alternative. So I definitely recommend that you ask your doctor about doing subcutaneous injections. Myth number 14, changes are linear. One thing that often comes as a surprise is that somewhere around the 3 month mark, a lot of people go through a sort of like chubbier face phase. I'm not clear on exactly how or why it happens, but before your face gets like a sharper jawline, you might actually feel like your face has gotten rounder than it was before. And if you don't know this is coming, you might think it's like the permanent way that T has made your face look. So just keep in mind that for the first couple of years, your body might do weird things that aren't gonna be the final result. Like the hair loss, you know, it starts and then stops and then maybe we'll start again sometime, maybe not. Remember, this is basically puberty you're going through, and puberty is freaking weird. Myth number 15, all changes are permanent. Most are, but not all. You can't ungrow facial and body hair, but you will stop growing more if you go off T. Your voice might get a little higher, but it won't go back to how it was. Fat will redistribute to a more feminine shape, your period will come back, and your skin will probably clear up. The main thing to know is that changes on T happen slowly, over months to years. And if you're nervous about certain changes, you can talk to your doctor about starting on a lower dose for probably slower changes. One shot of T is not going to turn you into a permanent burly man overnight. And myth number 15, testosterone will solve all of my problems. You will probably be happier, yes. And if you have anxiety and depression, they might decrease, at least temporarily. And this is probably because of how you feel in your body and how people are treating you, not because of testosterone itself. And it's definitely not guaranteed. I mean, you might even feel more dysphoric in some areas, like maybe socially, maybe about parts of your body that T isn't changing. And like any change in life, you can't expect it to be the cure-all for every problem and hardship that you have. Hormone replacement therapy is an amazing thing for the right people, but it's not right for everyone. And it's not a magic potion. So I hope those Mythbusters were helpful or educational for you. Please leave any of your questions, fears, or your own experiences with taking tea in the comments so we can all weigh in. And thank you again to Dollar Shave Club for sponsoring this video. If you liked this video, please subscribe for more videos every Wednesday. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram at @JackIsNotABird. And that is it for now. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.